Hai semua, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan selamat sejahtera. Okey, so dalam video ni, kita masih lagi dengan chapter 3. So, kita nak masuk ke part yang ke-9, which is kita nak tengok contoh macam mana kita nak solve non-homogeneous system of first order LDE bagi case yang mana dia punya function tu is a combination cases. Maksudnya dia punya apa function of G it is a combination either exponent with polynomial or maybe polynomial with trigonometry and so on. Okay. So, kita terus pergi kepada contoh. Okay. So, the question here, find the particular solution of the following non-homogeneous system of first order linear differential equation as below. So, dia dah bagi satu system of non-homogeneous system and then dia juga bagi kita initial condition. So, from here, kita kena dapatkan dia punya particular solution. So, dia punya solution, first of all, we need to find the complementary function yc for the homogeneous system. So, as usual, you need to write in the matrix form. But here, the question already give you in term of the matrix form. So, you just copy sajalah. Okay, so and then after that, step number 2, you need to find the eigenvalue lambda 1 and lambda 2 for the corresponding eigenvector V1. Okay, so how to find the eigenvalue? So, macam biasa, from the matrix A, element at 1, 1 and element at the 2, 2, we need to minus with lambda. Okay, so here -3 minus lambda, here 1, here is 2 and -4 minus lambda. So find try to calculate the determinant value, and then the determinant value must be equal to 0. Okay, so we just do the crossing addition. So -3 minus lambda multiply with -4 minus lambda minus 2 multiply with 1. So we try to simplify the equation. We got lambda squared plus 7 lambda plus 10 equal to 0. Okay, so you solve the quadratic equation by using your calculator. You get lambda is equal to negative 2 and negative 5. Alright, so next we can go to the, okay, so we can consider the eigenvalue is a real and different. Okay, so once you have your eigenvalue, now you can calculate the eigenvector. So, for the first eigenvalue, the for lambda 1, we assume eigenvector is V1. Okay, so for eigenvalue, lambda 1 is negative 2. So, we just do the operation of AV is equal to lambda V. So, A is a matrix A multiply with V is the eigenvector X1 and Y1. Lambda is a negative 2 and V is X1 and Y1. So, after that, we just do the matrix multiplication accordingly. So, what we have, -3 X1. Plus y1 equal to -2 x1. Okay, so from here we further simplify it. We get y1 is equal to x1. For the second row, we do the matrix multiplication 2x1 minus 4y1 equal to -2y1. Okay, from there, we try to simplify the equation so that we have y1 is equal to x1. Once you have this equation, you let x1 is equal to 1. If x1 is equal to 1, so your y1 is also equal to 1. So, the eigenvector is given by V1 is equal to 1 and 1. Right, so this is the first eigenvector. For the second eigenvector lambda 2, sorry, for the second eigenvalue lambda 2, the eigenvector is given by V2. V2 is x2 and y2. So, the lambda 2 is equal to negative 5. So, from the equation of AV equal to lambda V, you just substitute all the value accordingly. So, matrix A is given by this. Matrix of vector V, and this vector V is given by x2 and y2. So, lambda is negative 5. And then we just do the matrix multiplication. -3 x2 plus y2 equal to negative 5 x2. We further simplify. We got y2 is equal to negative 2 x2. Okay. So, same goes to the second row. You have y2 is equal to negative 2 x2. Okay. So, let x2 is equal to 1. So, when x2 is equal to 1, y2 is equal to negative 2 multiply with 1. So, you have negative 2. So, the eigenvector is given by 1 and negative 2. Alright? After you have the eigenvector ready, so you need to check the eigenvector whether it is linearly independent or not. Okay, so we just calculate the determinant value. So the determinant value for the eigenvector given by 1 multiplied with negative 2 is negative 2 minus 1. Okay, negative 2 minus 1 is negative 3. So negative 3 is not equal to 0. So when it is not equal to 0, we consider it as a linearly independent. So when it is linearly independent, we can just jump to the step number 4, we need to write the general solution. Okay, so the general solution ycx is given by c1 v1. V1 is 1 and 1. Okay, exponent lambda 1. Lambda 1 is negative 2x plus c2. V2 is 1 and negative 2. Exponent lambda 2x is negative 5. So exponent negative 5x. Okay, so this is the complementary function. Okay, so once you have the complementary function, you need to find the particular integral yp for the non-homogeneous system by using the method of undetermined coefficient. Okay, so in order to assume the yp, yp is assumed based on the type of g. Okay, so here what we have, g is a combination of polynomial and exponent. Here you have polynomial, here you have exponent. Okay, so what we can do, we can try to split the function so that we have here we have a function of exponent, and here we have a function of polynomial. Okay, once you split it into two different matrix, then we can assume yp is given by, so here is a yp for g, this is yp for when the function is exponent, and this is yp when the function is polynomial. Okay, and then once you have your yp, you need to compare this yp with the yc. Okay, so in this case, your yp is not equal to yc. So you can straight away do the differentiation for the yp in order to obtain the yp prime. Okay, so from here you differentiate exponent negative x, so you have negative 1. Okay, so negative 1 multiplied with u1 u2 exponent negative x plus, you differentiate this, you have you differentiate v1x, you got v1. Okay, so that's why here we have v1 and v2. Okay, w1 you differentiate, you got 0. So okay, so this is the yp prime. Okay, so next we need to compare the yp prime that we obtained from step 2 with the y prime that we obtained from the question. Okay, and then after that, we need to do the equating of the coefficient to get the value of u1, u2, v1, v2, and w1, w2. Okay, so from the question, y prime is given by this equation. And then from the step 2 above, yp prime is given by this equation. Okay, so we just compare this equation with this equation. So what we have, this is the yp prime equal to, this is y prime from the question. Okay, and then here we have y matrix. Y we need to substitute with the value of yp. Okay, so this is the yp, and then after that, once we substitute, we need to expand the equation by do the matrix multiplication between this matrix and this matrix. Okay, so what we have, negative 3 u1 plus u2. Okay, and then we have 2 u1 minus 4 u2. Okay, and then we have negative 3 v1 plus v2. Okay, so we have 2 v1 minus 4 v2. Alright, so next, negative 3 w1 plus w2, and then we have 2 w1. Minus 4 W2, right? Once we expand all the equation, we can rearrange the equation according to its coefficient. Okay, so for a coefficient exponent negative x, because you can like have 2 U1 minus 4 U2 plus 1. Okay, so for coefficient of x, you can have negative 3 V1 plus V2 plus 1. Alright, so the rest we just copy just like it is. Okay, after we rearrange according to its coefficient, we can just proceed with the equating of the coefficient. Okay, so for the first of coefficient of exponent negative x, what we have is negative u1 u2 is equal to this matrix. Okay, so what you have, negative P1 equaling is equal to this. Okay, so after that, we can just try to simplify row by row. For the first row, negative U1 is equal to negative 3U1 plus U2. Okay, and then we try simplify it. We get U2 is equal to 2U1. For the second row, negative U2 is equal to 2U1 minus 4U2 plus 1. And then after that, we just substitute the value of U2 here into here. So we further simplify it. You get U1 is equal to 1 over 4. Okay, once you have the value of U1, you can now calculate the value of U2. So U2 is equal to 2 multiplied with 1 over 4. You get 1 over 2. So this is the value for U1 and U2. Next, for the coefficient of x, so the equation is given by this. Okay, so we try to solve it by row by row. For the first row, 0 is equal to negative 3v1 plus v2 plus 1. So we rearrange it so that we have v2 is equal to 3v1 minus 1. And then for the second row, 0 is equal to 2v1 minus 4v2. And then we just substitute the value of v2 into this equation. So try to simplify it. We got 10v1 is equal to 4, so v1 is equal to 2 over 5. Once you have the value of v1, substitute into here, so v2 is equal to 3 multiplied with 2 over 5, you got 6 over 5. 6 over 5 minus 1 is equal to 1 over 5. Okay, so finally, your v1 and v2 is given by 2 over 5 and 1 over 5. Alright, so next, for the coefficient of x to the power of 0, so the equation is given by this. Okay, so we just solve it one by one. For the first, before that, the value of v1 and v2 is 2 over 5 and 1 over 5. So we just substitute into here. After that, we can try to solve the equation by row by row. For the first row, 2 over 5 is equal to negative 3w1 plus w2. And then we rearrange it. So we have w2 is equal to 2 over 5 plus 3w1. Okay, for the second row, 1 over 5 is equal to 2w1 minus 4w2. Okay, after that, you can just substitute the value of W2 into this equation. So, you can rearrange it so that you can find the value of W1. So, finally, W1 is equal to negative 9 over 50. After that, you just substitute back the value of W1 into W2. So, W2 is given by negative 7 over 50. So, finally, W1 and W2 is given by negative 9 over 50 and negative 7 over 50. Alright, so finally the YP is given by, you just substitute the value of U1, V1 and W1 accordingly. Alright, so next, once we have the value of YC and YP, we can find the general solution. So the general solution is equal to YC plus YP. Okay, so this is the general solution of the system of the first order LDE. Okay, next. We go to the next part. Next part, we need to find a particular solution by considering the initial condition. So, the initial condition is given by when x equal to 0, y1 is equal to 0, and y2 is equal to 0. So, you just substitute accordingly. So, now, your y1 is 0, y2 is 0, x also 0. Okay. So, after that, we can just try to solve it row by row. So, for the first row, 0 is equal to c1 plus c2 plus 1 over 4. Minus 9 over 50. Okay, and then we try to simplify it. We get this equation. For the second row, 0 is equal to C1 minus 2C2 plus 1 over 2 minus 7 over 50. Just substitute this equation into this equation. Try to simplify it so that you can have the value of C2. So C2 is equal to 29 over 300. After that, you just substitute back this value into here. Now, I have C1 is equal to negative 1 over 6. Okay, so once you have the value of C1, the value of C2, you can just substitute back into the general solution so that you can have your particular solution. So, this is the final answer for the question. So, this is the particular solution for the system of first order LDE given in the question. Okay, so thanks for watching. Good luck to every one of you. Bye.